बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम स्टूडेंट टू क्लास 7। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर यूनिट 3 विच टाइटल इज द मोस्ट वैल्यूएबल गिफ्ट। दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड आई होप यू आर गोइंग टू लाइक इट। फ्रॉम द लाइफ ऑफ मिस्टर अहमद वी कम टू नो दैट द मोस्ट वैल्यूएबल गिफ्ट ऑफ लाइफ इज टाइम विच वी कैन गिव टू अदर्स especially in this age when everyone is busy. Now look at page number 1. We are going to read it and find out the meanings of difficult words, and then I am going to explain. Ahmed was a successful businessman. He worked 24/7 to establish his business. Marriage, other commitment and life itself never got in his way. Ahmed moved all over the country in pursuit of his dreams. There, in the rush of his busy life, Ahmed had no time to think about the past and often little time to spend with his wife and son. He kept working on his future and nothing could stop him. One day, his mother called him over the phone. She told him, "Mr. Hashim died last night. The funeral is on Wednesday." Memories flashed through his mind like an old scroll picture as he sat quietly remembering his childhood days. He had been some time since he had last seen the old man. He was so hard at work and led such a hectic life that he didn't even have time to think about Mr. Hashim. "Ahmed, do you hear me?" his mother asked. "Oh, sorry, mother. Yes, I heard you. It's been so long since I thought of him. I am sorry, but I honestly forgot about him," Emma said. "Well, he didn't forget you. Every time I saw him, he would ask, 'How were you doing?' He would reminisce about the days you spent with his side of the fence, as he put it," his mother told him. "I loved the old house he lived in," said Ahmed. "You know, Ahmed, after your father had died, Mr. Hashim stepped in to make sure you had a father's care in your life," he said. "He is the one who taught me carpentry," he said. Now look at the meaning of difficult words. Number 1, 24/7. What does it mean, 24 hours a day and 7 days a week? Hard at work, working very hard. Hectic means very busy, tiring. Reminisce means remember about past. What is told in the first page of this chapter, we come to know that Mr. Ahmed is a successful businessman. He is very hardworking. He worked day and night to establish his business. Even he forgot all about other things. One day his mother called him and told about him, about the death of Mr. Hashim. He was surprised. His mother reminded him that after the death of his father, it was Mr. Hashim who looked after him. He decided to attend his funeral because he was very attached with Mr. Hashim during his childhood. Though in this busy life he forgot about him, but now he decided to go and attend his funeral. Now look at the last line and then we continue from the second page. "I wouldn't have been in this business if it weren't for him. He spent a lot of time teaching me the things he thought were important, mother. I will be there for a funeral," Ahmed said. Though he was busy, he kept his word. Ahmed caught the next flight to his hometown. Mr. Hashim's funeral was small and uneventful. He had no children of his own and most of his relatives had passed away. The night before he had to return home, Ahmed, his mother, stopped by to see the old house next door one more time. Standing by the doorway, Ahmed paused for a moment. It was like crossing over into another dimension, a leap through space and time. The house was exactly as he remembered. Every step held memories, every picture, every piece of furniture. Ahmed stopped suddenly. "What's wrong, Ahmed?" his mother asked. "The box is gone," he said. "What box?" his mother asked. "There was a small gold box that he kept locked on the top of his desk. I must have asked him 1,000 times what was inside. All he would never tell me what the thing I value the most," he said. "It was gone. Everything about the house was exactly how Ahmed remembered it, except for the box. He figured that someone from Mr. Hashim's family had taken it. Now I will never know what was so valuable to him." He said, I better get some sleep. I have an early flight back home. It had been about 2 weeks since Mr. Hashim died. Returning from work, one day Emma discovered a note in his mailbox, signature required on the package. No one at home, please stop by the main post office within the next 3 days, the note read. Early the next day, Ahmed retrieved the package. The small box was old and looked like it had been mailed 100 years ago. The handwriting was difficult to read, but the return address caught his attention. Mr. Ali Hashim, it read, Ahmedpur, took the box out of the car and ripped open the package. There inside was a gold box. Now, look at the meaning of difficult words on page 2. Kept his word means fulfilled his promise. Stopped by, made a short visit. Paused, stopped. Leaped through, a rapid change. Figured, estimated. Retrieved, got back. Ripped open, opened by tearing. Now what is told on the second page? We come to know that after funeral, he visited the Hashim's house. Everything was safe and nothing had changed, but only thing was missing, that was a small box. In the past, he asked from Mr. Hashim what was in the box, but Mr. Hashim always answered that he had the most valuable thing in the box, but he didn't reveal the secret, what is exactly in the box. He came back to his home wondering what could be in the box. After 2 weeks of the funeral, he received a parcel which contained the same box of Mr. Hashim, and he was surprised to find this gift from Mr. Hashim. Now, look at the last page of this chapter. And an envelope, Emma's hand shook as he read the note inside. Upon my death, please forward this book and its content to Ahmed Rahim. It is the thing I valued most in my life. A small key was tapped to the letter, his heart racing as tears filling his eyes. Mr. Ahmed carefully unlocked the box. There inside, he found a beautiful gold watch. Running his finger slowly over the finely etched casing, he unlatched the cover. Inside, he found these words engraved. Ahmed, thank you for your time, Ali Hashim. The thing he valued most was my time. Ahmed held the watch for a few minutes. Then he called his office and cleared his appointments for the next 2 days. Why? His assistant asked. I need some time to spend with my son and my family, he said. Then he thought for a moment and said again to his assistant, oh, by the way, thank you for your time. Life is not measured by the number of breaths we take, but by the moments that take away the breath. Time is the most precious gift one can give to the other person in this busy world. Now look at the meaning of difficult words. Etched means to cut lines into a piece of metal to write something. Unlatched, remove latch. Assistant, helper, one who helps. And precious means valuable. Now in the end, we come to know that he received a parcel which contained a golden watch, and what was written on it? Thanks for your time. It means that Mr. Hashim gave importance to time. Then Mr. Ahmed realized his mistake, that and he got to know that what was the most valuable thing of the life. And he was wondering, and he was surprised that even he, in his busy life, didn't give any quality time to his family and relatives. But from now, he learned a lesson that he is going to give a quality time to his family and relatives. And if time is the most precious gift which we can give to others, because in this busy life, no one has time for others, but from now, Mr. Ahmed has learned what is the most valuable gift of life. Students, thank you. I hope that you have all understood the lesson. If you have any difficulty, you can ask me. Thank you.